In this Blender tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can discover and fix undercuts for mold making in Blender. This is great if you're trying to make a mold and you need to know what parts are undercut so you can make your parting lines within Blender for 3D printing molds without undercuts. We're going to use the 3D Print Toolbox. This is a great tool and add-on that's free for Blender. I have a video linked in the description how to install the add-on. Once you have the add-on installed, you can press N on your keyboard. And then down under here, you'll see 3D Print. If we click Overhang, it'll tell us how many overhang faces there are. But notice we don't see anything. That's because you need to go into edit mode by pressing Tab and then select Overhang Faces. So if I select something here, I can't see the faces. But once again, if I click here, I can see the overhang faces. This would be great for 3D printing this model. We know where supports are. And perhaps we could remove some of the overhangs in the hair to have less supports. But we're more interested in creating a mold. So if I look at this model, I want to keep the details of the face. So I want to find out how I can have the biggest mold part of the face without undercuts. To do that, I'm going to rotate the model. So if I press RX90, it'll rotate the model. Now the face is pointed straight down. Then I can check overhangs by clicking overhang. And right now it's at 45 degrees. So let's go ahead and see what that looks like. Now I select overhang faces and it shows what is overhang. But this would definitely come out of a mold right here, these parts that are at an angle. That's because this is for 3D printing. So if we change the overhang from 45 degrees to 0 degrees, and then we check the overhang and then the overhang faces, this will show us what is vertically down. So now, depending on how you want to think about it, these dark areas down at the bottom of the face are undercuts. So this here is an undercut. This is an undercut by the nostrils, is an undercut underneath the lips, is an undercut, and under the chin is an undercut. The same thing if we look back at the hair here, we could smooth out some of these hair pieces here. And eventually, of course, the neck wraps all the way around. So this is an undercut. But you can start to see where our parting line may be. We could potentially smooth this out. It may not be 100% accurate to the model, but we could smooth this area out and have our parting line come down here. We may never get everything under the chin smoothed out, but there's a possibility. The same with the nose and the ears. But by going around and smoothing things out, we can eliminate many undercuts without necessarily changing the features of our model. So how can we do that? The easiest way is to use a combination of edit mode and sculpt mode. Here we can see this small undercut. This one will be very easy to fix. So if I change my mode to sculpt mode, notice everything disappears. But if I press tab, I can go straight back to edit mode. So an easy workflow, since this disappears in sculpt mode, is to press tab, hover your cursor where the undercut you want to fix is, press tab, then any tool, if you hold shift, becomes smooth, and I can just smooth that out in sculpt mode. Tab back to edit mode, check the overhangs by clicking overhang, then click overhang faces. That overhang is now gone. So that undercut has been removed. Let's try to make this bigger undercut. I'm starting in the hair because the hair doesn't matter so much. It can change. Whereas facial features and things, we need to be a bit more careful and perhaps make different mold pieces. Once again, I'll hover my cursor here, press tab, and then I can see the shadow here. So I'm just going to smooth this out. Most likely that won't change what's happening with the sculpture. Click overhang, then overhang faces. So this one is still overhang. Sometimes it's a good idea to kind of look to see what you're dealing with. I might want to build the material out a little bit right there. So I can do that by not holding the shift key. So I'll tab back into sculpt mode, just add a little material, and then smooth it out by holding the shift key. And of course, this will be different for every model and every situation. Tab back into edit mode, click overhang, then overhang faces. This one needs a little bit more removed on the top, so I think I'll just smooth that out since it's just a bit of hair here. Tab back into sculpt mode, hold shift, kind of blend it into the other shapes. Tab back into edit mode, overhang, overhang faces. That is no longer an undercut. Then we continue around to all the different parts, and as you go, You can see this is a simple undercut. Tab, hold shift, smooth that out a bit. Tab back to edit mode, overhang, overhang faces, that one is gone. Now, you want to pay attention to what you're doing because eventually everything can't be a non-undercut. For example, down here, I probably want to keep some of these because I could have the mold parting line pull the other direction. But I do need to decide where I want to have those parting lines. So probably somewhere up here along this hair, I want a nice smooth parting line because then I could break up the mold. This one here is probably something I want to correct. And of course, everything down here is different for a different section. So we can't have everything be non-undercut. So the same thing with the nose and things here and the ears I may want to deal with separately. So just kind of decide where you want that parting line to be. And I think on this face, I'm going to want to go around the face like this, and then I'll clean up the nose and things like that a little bit. So let's go in and see if we can start to do that. Once again, tab into sculpt mode. Just hold shift, smooth that out. Tab back into edit mode, click overhang, then overhang faces. One more undercut done. And as you get the easy ones, you can start to decide which hard ones are important for the detail of your model and which undercuts can be removed. So do all the easy ones first, and it'll give you a better picture of what you need to do. Tab once again, smooth this out, click overhang, overhang faces, gone. Fix these two really quick. And as we go along, it starts to clean up and make it obvious where we may want to have our parting line. For example, here, this starts to become part of the face. So this might be a little bit of the hair, but we could probably smooth out a little bit of this just to have a nice clean parting line. Tab into sculpt mode, tab back out, click overhang, then overhang faces. Once more, smoothing that out just a little bit. So now this parting line is working well, and then we'll move around. So how can we decide where a good parting line will be? One thing to do is to rotate the model. Be careful not to rotate it when you only have some things selected. So I can press A, then I can look at a cardinal direction such as the Y direction here. Then I can do R90 to rotate 90 degrees. If I click overhang, then overhang faces, now it's showing everything from this direction. And as you can see, I don't need to worry about all those undercuts from the ear in the other direction because I can pull off a nice sideways mold piece, which will work really well. Now I do have to worry about these undercuts, but I could decide potentially to have some of the ear shapes come out from the front of the mold and then the rest come from here. So I could easily have the ear come out sideways. So let's deal with these undercuts right here. I can zoom in, see this undercut, tab into sculpt mode, just smooth that just a little bit. We don't want to change the shape of the ears too much, but since this will be a slip cast model in clay, it won't matter completely what these details are. We just want the mold to come out cleanly. Tab back into edit mode, click overhang, overhang faces. That's almost done. Oh, it's just this lip right here on the ear. Tab back into edit mode, click overhang, overhang faces. That one's gone. We can smooth this one out too. Just a little bit more right there. So now those two small undercuts are gone. We need to deal with this undercut here. This is a little bit more major. These ones down here are pretty simple, so let's deal with these first. This one is going on the inside of the ear, so we can just knock this edge down a little bit, and then that'll be no problem. Tab back into sculpt mode. Overhang, overhang faces. Just knock a little bit more of this down. So now those undercuts on the ear are gone, and we just have this last undercut in the middle. If you're ever having issues deciding where to go or remembering, this is a little bit more complex of an undercut. If you're not sure what you need to change, you can use the materials to assign materials. So if I click on the material tab, and right now it has a material on there just as a matte cap, if I add a new material, and I can just label this undercut, give it a color, let's say yellow, so it's really easy to see. While I have all these spaces selected, I could either color these spaces the color or I could inverse. It's whatever you prefer. I'm just going to go ahead and assign to the faces here. Then if I click on material preview, you can see this will stay. And if I go to sculpt mode, I can now see that undercut. Now, the only downside of this is it doesn't update, but I can use this and see if I can figure out what the undercut is. So I can smooth this out and build up that undercut. As you can see, I'm building that undercut up with the sculpt tool. I think I'm going to change this material. Now I can see a little bit more. If you have a dark material on your model, it may help to change it. I picked a nice contrasting color. Now I can build this out so I can definitely make sure that that's not undercut. Opposite of what I want to do, I want to just build up this purple part and then smooth it out. If I build it up too much, I'll create undercuts behind it. I can knock down the front of this by holding the smooth key. Then if I tab back into edit mode, click overhang, overhang faces, you can see how much of that is now been gobbled up by our corrections. And you can continue this process. Now I need to select everything, assign the first material. So I press A, assign that first material, then click overhang faces, then assign our undercut material. Then I can tab back into sculpt mode and I can see what's missing. So here I can just smooth that out. Probably back in here, this needs to be built up. And just smooth that so it looks like it's coming straight in and there's not going to be any problems pulling that mold piece out. Then tab back into edit mode, click overhang, overhang faces. So all of that down there is all gone. I think I could just smooth this out a little bit without redoing the color. So I'll tab back into sculpt mode, build that up a little bit, smooth it out, then tab back into edit mode, overhang, overhang faces, and we're just about there. Tab into sculpt mode. Then in edit mode, click overhang, then overhang faces. Just a few more right here. Smooth that out, maybe build that up a little bit. Tab back in edit mode, click overhang, then overhang faces. Just this last little bit in the back here, smooth that down, tab, overhang, overhang faces. So sometimes it can be a little bit problematic. So we can see here that coming straight out of the ear, really this piece is just a lot lower. So I think we need to build it up more in the back with the sculpt tools. Might raise my brush just a little bit and smooth that out. So now that is all no undercut. So the entire ear can pull straight out. So we don't have to worry about the undercut. So now we could make a parting line along the face here, have the ear pull out, have a parting line here, and then all of this could pull to the back. So depending on how your sculpture is, you can decide where the different parting lines need to be. So I'm going to go ahead and finish. Remember that the materials here don't update. So if you want to use materials to help you identify where to work, make sure that you select everything, assign the main material, then check the overhangs, click the overhang faces, then assign the undercut to those faces. So this way you can see the difference in sculpt mode. Otherwise, this doesn't dynamically update. Remember that even though there are undercuts on the nose here, this is going to pull out from the front. So you need to keep rotating the model and then updating the analysis after you make corrections. Hopefully this allows you to remove all the undercuts from your model in Blender. Happy 3D modeling.